अमानत से कोई सवाल नहीं पूछती। लेकिन इन लोगों को एयरफोर्स की ताकत पर विश्वास नहीं है, इसने साफ साफ यह कहा है। बीजेपी की ओर से हमारा स्पष्ट कहना है यह सब कुछ राहुल गांधी के इशारे पर हो रहा है। और यह बात मैं आपसे इसलिए कह रहा हूं, याद करिए दो दिन पहले राहुल गांधी की प्रेस में आप लोगों ने एक सवाल पूछा था दिग्विजय सिंह के कमेंट पर, कपिल सिब्बल चिदंबरम के कमेंट पर, राहुल गांधी ने कोई जवाब नहीं दिया था। तो राहुल गांधी के की अगुवाई में, राहुल गांधी के प्रोत्साहन में सेना के ऊपर अनावश्यक हमले किए जा रहे हैं। अच्छा है वो पाकिस्तान में खूब दिखेंगे, लेकिन भारत राष्ट्र ऐसे महान देश का एक आईन भी तो होता है ना, उसकी एक क्षमता प्रतिभा, उसका एक आदर होता है ना। क्या ये सेना को कब तक आप इस तरह का पॉलिटिक्स का केंद्र बनाएंगे अपनी छोटी सियासत के लिए? चुनाव आएंगे जाएंगे, पार्टियां जीतेंगी हारेंगी, लेकिन देश रहेगा और देश की सेना रहेगी। और मैं हमेशा कहता हूं देश के लिए जीते तो हम सब हैं, देश के लिए मरते हैं, शहीद होते हैं हमारे सेना और पैरामिलिट्री के लोग। अब क्या उनकी शहादत पर भी सवाल उठाए जा रहे हैं? तो हम इसका जबरदस्त प्रतिकार करते हैं, इसकी भर्त्सना करते हैं। और राहुल गांधी जी, अगर आप में कुछ शर्म बची है देश के लिए, तो अपने इन नेताओं पर आप कृपया करके नियंत्रण करें। दैट्स ऑल। I see a lot of sponsored comment happening today, notably from Mamta ji and some others, that in the whole election program, Ramzan is going to be affected. I would like to gently remind those leaders, don't be so desperate. Even Holi is coming in the election campaign. Even the Chait Navratri is coming in the election campaign, program period. And for them, just to know that last year the Kerala by-election took place during the Ramadan period itself. So also I am told the Noorpur by-election. So many elections have taken place. Yes, I can understand on the exact day of polling, there should not be a festival. Therefore, this comment by itself is an indication of desperation of leaders who are fearing imminent defeat. I have heard that Congress party and their associates are also charging us for trying to weaken the institutions of India. Come on, who is saying that? Who unleashed a torrent of abuse against the Election Commission in the wake of EVMs? The Congress party and the associates. Who has refused to accept the verdict of the Supreme Court in the wake of Rafael? The Congress party and their associates. Raising the same question again and again, which has been rejected by the Supreme Court. Who unleashed abuse on the CVC, the Congress party, and their associates? They were Congress, please look inwards as to how you all have been abusing recognized institutions of India. Those who do their bidding are okay. Those who don't are subject to abuse. That is what the Congress party is about. Lastly, this morning I have heard that Mr. Farooq Abdullah and some other leaders have again raised doubts about the surgical strike by the Air Force. No country in the world is asking evidence. They are believing India's story. The Air Force chief has said categorically it has happened. There is substantial contemporaneous evidence available of the long-term damage. Pakistan is not permitting international media to go to Balakot area where the strike took place. But you don't believe this demeaning, the sacrifice and the valor of the forces is most condemnable. We all live for the country, the security forces and the paramilitary forces who die for the nation. Let's learn to respect that. But the silence of Mr. Rahul Gandhi is absolutely conspicuous and surprising. He did not dissociate from the comments of Digvijay Singh, Kapil Sibal and Chidambaram. Even in the press conference, he did not give a reply. We are very clear. All this is happening because of the instigation, patronage, and direction of Rahul Gandhi. The country surely will give a fitting reply. Thank you.